So this is the problem with the multi-scan Sony Trinitron E500 model. Basically, what you can see there is it should be a black screen from a scaler unit that I've got hooked up to this monitor, but it should be black. Well, looking at that through the viewfinder, it is green. And if I actually, let's see how I can do this. Right, that's at 20% brightness. So if I turn the brightness right down, it does get rid of it quite a lot, but it's still, it's still nowhere near dull enough. So if I just take that to even 50% brightness, so that's 50%. That's 50% brighter, and just look how bright it is. It's actually green. It is green. Strangely enough, well, okay, not strangely enough, because I know what the problem is. But if we look at a normal background there, or a normal image on the on it. So if I just pull the menu up, actually, there you go. So white's a white, blues are blues, yellows are yellows, and greens will be greens. So it is a lot better when there is an image on there. But if you can imagine, if you get black anywhere, it will have this this tinge to it, so you can't actually use it, to be fair. And actually, even the white, looking at it on the screen, not through the viewfinder, it has got a green tinge to it still. So it's something you can't get rid of. Now, I actually thought that I've had the whole back off this, took all the guts out, and to me it's a screen voltage issue. And after looking online, it is a common fault with these monitors, which is obviously sort of masked when you get a full screen image on there, but it's still there and it's just not good enough. I'm not happy with this. I'm not, you know, I'm not going to keep this monitor because it's just not not right. And I've actually looked at the chassis, and unfortunately on this chassis there is no adjustment on the flyback transformer. Normally what you can do is actually turn the voltage down of effectively the energy that comes through to the CRT, and there is no adjustability on that voltage, and nothing that I can see, certainly not on a rotary potentiometer or adjuster, which you get on arcade monitors and actually also normal CRT TVs. So it's a bit of a sort of bind. I thought I could actually fix this, but I can't. Not easily. I'm sure if I change some components, I might be able to sort it out, but there doesn't seem to be anything online to enable you to do that. And to be honest, I'm not that really bothered about it. I'm not going to be messing around with it. So unfortunately, guys, this monitor is going to end up going down the tip. It did only cost me £5 or £6 or whatever it was. It wasn't that much, so I'm not particularly bothered about it. And in some way, shape or form, I'm sort of glad in a way, because it means I can clear this out of the house, because I've already got a CRT already, a PC CRT, and it's a bit more of a manageable size of 17 inches. So this one at 21 inches is a bit of a humongous monitor, but yeah, it's a bit of a shame really, but you know, those are the breaks. So yeah, so if you are looking for a CRT monitor, don't get an E500, because if you put E500 in issues into Google, you'll get all sorts of problems around this particular issue. So it seems pretty common fault. So unfortunately, it's not the monitor to be.